Welcome back to Lockdown Morse. First, I want to thank all of you for the positive comments you've left in the first video. I really do appreciate you taking the time to let me know what you think. One comment was that the speed of the Morse characters seemed a little fast. I've deliberately set the character speed higher than you might expect, as this will make it easier to increase your speed as the course progresses. If you learn using slower character speeds, as the overall rate increases, you'll need to relearn the characters at faster speeds. In these videos, the only thing that will happen is that, over time, the gaps between the letters and the words will shorten. There's also a danger of counting the dits and dahs in a character when they're played at very low speeds, which means you're not learning the sound of them automatically. An H, for example, is 4 dits. The number 5 is 5 dits. By learning the characters at higher speeds, you'll learn the pattern of the sounds rather than counting the individual parts. I hope that explains the reason for the high character speed. If you feel like you need extra tracks, or if you'd just like to support me in completing more of these videos, you can look at joining my Patreon. For £2 a month, you'll get access to MP3 files with worksheets, and as the course progresses, there'll be extra videos as well. In this video, we're going to learn the letters U, Y, and Z. We'll start by recapping the letters we've learnt so far, which are, in alphabetical order, A, E, I, and O. First, we'll have 10 groups of 5 characters with just the letters A and E. So here we go. We'll now have 10 groups of 5 of the letters I and O. Here we go. I know that people struggle between A and I. This is normal because they're so similar. I haven't made a track with just A and I because learning two such similar letters together can actually make things more difficult. When you know which letters to expect, but they're very similar, you can pause to rehear the letter in your head just to check you've got it right. Remember that if you don't know a letter straight away, you need to force yourself to ignore it and move on to the next letter. This is by far the hardest thing I'll ask you to do. There'll be other opportunities for you to practice missing characters before we learn the next letter. Now though, here's a track of all the letters we've learnt so far. A, E, I and O, 10 groups of 5 characters. Here we go. And here's another 10 groups. And one more lot of 10 groups. I'll now play you 5 groups of 6 characters. This time you'll have letters that you haven't learnt yet. If you don't know the letter, move on to the next. Okay, here we go. Okay, we'll now do another five. So here we go. And this is what you should have copied. We'll have one more group of all the characters we've learnt so far, then we'll move on to the next letter. This time it will be 10 groups of 6 characters. Here we go. If you're still struggling with any of the vowels we've learnt so far, you might want to re-watch this video from the start. Don't worry about copying something you've already heard, it won't slow you down. The next letter we're going to learn is U. This is U in 2 groups of 5. Now you'll hear 5 groups of U of different lengths between 1 and 5 characters. Write a U every time you hear one and leave a space whenever there's a gap. Here's the track. Okay, and another 5 groups of varying lengths. We'll now have 8 groups of the letters U and I between 1 and 5 characters in length. Here we go. And one more group in the same way. Now we'll have 8 groups of all the letters we've learnt so far. And now another 8 groups. And now another 8 groups. We're now going to have a longer track, the longest one you've heard so far. This track is 25 groups of 5 characters. This time I want you to write down everything you hear, leaving a gap whenever you miss a letter, but you'll then hear the track a second time, so you can follow what you've heard and fill in the gaps. You can repeat this as many times as you want. before moving on to the next letter. So here's the track for the first time. Okay, and here's the track again. Remember, you can go back and repeat this as many times as you need to. Thank you. If you're still unsure of the letter U, look in the video description and you'll see a timestamp for where it's first introduced. You can work through the video from there again. We're now going to learn the letter Y. This is the first character made up of four parts. We'll hear it now in two groups of five. Now, as usual, five groups of Y of different lengths between one and five characters. Just write whenever you hear a Y and then leave a gap wherever there's a gap. Here's the first track. And now another five groups. And now here are eight groups of varying lengths of just the letters U and Y. Here we go. And another eight groups of just the letters U and Y. Thank you. there'll now be 4 tracks. Each track will consist of 8 groups of varying lengths. Here's the first. And here's the next group of 8. Okay, and another group of 8. And this is the final group of 8. If you're still unsure of the letter Y, look in the video description and you'll see a timestamp for where it's first introduced. You can work through the video from there again. You're now going to hear your first words. For these, try not to write or type anything until you've heard the whole word. Each word will play twice. So listen to the Morse and try to picture the letters in your head. Once you've heard it twice, you can then write it or type it if you'd like. This is called head copying. and it's an additional skill which will take practice, so if you can't get it straight away, please don't worry. Here's the first word, again you'll hear it twice. Don't write or type anything until you've heard it the second time. And here's another word, again played twice. And another word. And a final word. We'll have a long track now, which is 25 groups of 5 characters. As with last time, I'll play it twice, so try to copy as much as you can without struggling over any letters, and then fill in the gaps you missed before when you hear it the second time. You can repeat this as many times as you need to. So here's the track for the first time. and here's the track for the second time. We're now going to learn the letter Z. First, you'll hear the letter Z in two groups of five. Now, as usual, here five groups of the letter Z of different lengths. Here's the first one. And here's the next one. Thank you. We'll now hear 8 groups of the letters Y and Z. And another 8 groups. And another 8 groups. We'll now have 8 groups of all the letters you've learnt so far. And another 8 groups. Thank you. and another 8 groups. And a final group. We'll now move on to your words. Remember, they'll be played twice. Don't write or type anything until you hear it the second time. Here's the first word. And here's the next word. And here's the next word. Here's another word. And here's the final word. You'll now hear a long track, 25 groups of 5 characters. Remember, you can listen to it as many times as you want, but please don't struggle over individual letters. Here's the track for the first time. And here it is again. Finally, now that you've learnt a few letters, you can easily do some homework whenever you see written text. Signs, number plates, newspaper headlines, disciplinary letters and books are all great examples of text that can be readily translated. Whenever you see a letter you've already learnt, just think of the sound of the letter, or if you're alone, you can always make the noise of it. Just remember, don't try to see it written down. A, for example, sounds like dida and not dot dash. Y sounds like da-da-di-da and not dash-dash-dot-dash. If you're not in a place where you can sound the letters out loud, you can do them in your head, you can tap them on your steering wheel, or you can blink at unsuspecting colleagues. To begin with, here's a paragraph that you can look through. This is the final part of this video, so thanks again for joining in, and I'll see you next time.